tutorial video for the rollover. The rollover is the third exercise used in Joseph Pilates' Contrology routine, and an exercise I use in my own Nourishing Moves program as well. Often I'll use the rollover after the roll up, as the roll up will take your ribs to your hips, working on a forward bend. The rollover will do the opposite, taking the hips towards the ribs. So the best way for me to put this across for you is for me to demonstrate the rollover, and then I'll walk you through the alternatives I use, which will build people up to do a good rollover. This is a very challenging move. It's an advanced exercise, one which will loosen the back of the legs, articulate and mobilise the spine, and create a lot of strength through the midsection. So this is the rollover. Okay, so as you can see, there's quite a stretch in the movement. It does require a lot of strength here. So what I'll often get people to do to start with, to learn the feeling of the movement, is what I call the knee push. So you lay flat on the floor, and you just want to check the neck's nice and soft, the shoulders are away from your ears, and then bring the knees up to a tabletop position, and place your hands on your knees. And the idea is you want to think about lengthening through your lower back and curling so that the knees will push into your hands like this. And you'll feel that pressure from the knees into the hands. And you should feel it coming from here. That's teaching you to activate that area. And you want to imagine that you're lengthening your lower back. You're trying to keep your jaws soft and your neck soft and your shoulders and chest quiet. The movement all comes from this center. And once you've got the hang of that, I would work into this reverse curl, second movement. So the reverse curl starts in tabletop again. You straighten the legs very slightly, and you're working on using that lengthening of your lower back to curl the knees into your chest. And you're doing this while stretching the fingertips away from you, drawing the shoulders away from your ears. And when you can manage that, you'll be ready for the hip lift. So you'd straighten the legs this time, asks for much more flexibility in the back of the legs. Try to aim to have your ankles roughly above the hips. And you use the same idea, that lengthening and lifting from your lower back using your midsection. So it will look like this. And again, trying to stay soft and quiet here in the jaw, in the shoulders, in the chest, always walking the fingers away from you. So when you can manage that, you're ready for the full rollover. Sometimes I'll give people this little abbreviation to start with. It can be a nice idea to start off with the straight legs, bend the legs in towards you, roll over, then straighten the legs to help you over. And tuck the legs in as you roll back down. So you tuck them in, roll over and lengthen. Tuck in and roll back down. And what that will do is help your legs to work as kind of like a weight to help the body curl, help the spine curl, but without too much stretch in the back of your legs. When you are ready for the full roll over, I really want you to think about where you're directing the energy. And the energy wants to be going out of your feet. It wants to be stretching out of your hands, but also away from the taking out through the crown of the head. So there's these main directions. So with the full rollover, legs to tabletop, straighten the legs out, roughly 45, 65 degrees. Take a deep, low, wide breath in, and on the exhalation, roll the legs over. In this stretched position, breathe in low and wide into the ribs while stretching your fingertips away. And as you breathe in, you flex your feet, open the feet and the legs hip or mat width apart. And on the exhalation, roll back. back into the mat, articulating through your spine. Breathe in, the feet come together. Breathe out, curl over, creating length through the fingertips, length out through the toes and the crown of the head, pushing away with the spine, creating a nice C shape in the midsection. Breathe in, and breathe out, back down. Once you've done a few repetitions there, you would do it in reverse. So you would take the feet over with them apart, mat width apart. Breathe in, the feet come together, and then pace back down into the mat. Breathe in, feet apart. Roll over, breathe in, breathe out, pace back down. Okay, it is a challenging move, and much like the roll up, sometimes it's people's lower back which lacks flexibility, which is the main limiting factor here. And as I did with the roll up, I would put sometimes a little pad, a soft block or a rolled up towel underneath the lumbar area of the spine. And that will help give, help fill that space and help people to go over or roll over. So I'd put this under the lower back here. And then you'll notice it can be much easier when you roll over this way. Okay. So give that movement a try. And if you have any questions or comments, do let me know in the comments section below, and I'll try and answer them as best I can. Thank you very much for watching.